there's a shortcut this way?
Yes. Look, there it is.
That's the shortcut?
I know a shortcut when I see one.
Some shortcut.
Well, at least I... Hey, look! I think I know that herd.
I do too. It's Allie! Allie's come back. Let's go see her.
I wish we had a shortcut.
All I see is the day in front of us.
All I see is the day in front of us.
Burning bright with a newborn sun.
Newborn
come
sun.
Follow me.
Hills to climb and valleys to roam.
Oh,
streams to follow on our way home. To the land before time.
Play?
Who is this Rhett guy?
I am Rhett.
Well, I'm Sarah, and this is Littlefoot. We're Allie's old friends.
Tell them.
Rhett is very brave, but he won't play with kids he doesn't know.
That doesn't sound very brave.
Oh, yeah, little Nick.
My name is Littlefoot.
Well, I'm Rhett the Brave, hero of the herd, scarer of the sharp teeth.
Hero of the herd?
Scarer of the sharp teeth?
The ones we've seen aren't scared of flying rocks, earthshakes, or smoking mountains.
Let alone little longnecks.
Well, they're scared of me.
Tell them all about your adventures, Rhett.
Well, while you kids have been living here safe all the time, I've been in the mysterious beyond protecting my herd. Stay back. I'll handle this. Scared of those flying rocks. Now, another time, the herd was being chased. That was a close one.
That's some tale.
I know. And then there was the time I used my tail to build a mountain of rocks that the sharp teeth couldn't climb. No food for you! You're safe now. Let's go! And you haven't heard anything yet.
I think we've heard enough.
We've heard plenty.
So, Allie, were you with Rhett when any of this stuff happened?
No. That happened before our herds joined up.
And you really believe that he built a mountain of rocks with his tail?
While being chased by sharp teeth?
Oh, well, that mountain of rocks was mostly built. But I did finish the top.
See? He finished the top!
Of a mountain? That's pretty hard to believe.
You're just mad because you can't knock down trees with your tail.
Come on, Sarah. I guess we're just not brave enough to play with Allie anymore.
Wanna play rescue?
Okay.
I can't believe Allie believes those crazy stories.
We were her friends.
Well, it's not fair. He can't be her best friend.
I don't care. The stories he's telling are phony.
To meet him.
No, Petrie. Rhett's making stuff up and has convinced Allie he's telling the truth.
Allie thinks he's so brave, and he's not. It makes me so mad.
I'm angry, too.
Well, the longer you're mad, the less you're happy.
So, what we do?
I don't know, Petrie, but we gotta find a way to show Allie the truth.
Yeah.
I guess I could just try telling Allie that Rhett is making stuff up again.
But what if she does not believe you again?
What if Rhett hit you with tail?
We need to show Allie that Rhett's not as brave as he says.
Yeah. I'd like to see what Rhett would do if a real sharp tooth came around.
Wait! What if we really did have him face a real sharp tooth?
You want to bring a real sharp tooth into the Great Valley?
I don't know if that plan's such a good plan. My plan is to use a sharp tooth that's already here.
There's sharp tooth in Great Valley!
Yep, and he's right here.
You mean me?
But Chomper is nice. He is.
We know Chomper's nice, but you don't know that until you know him.
And Allie and Rhett have never met Chomper.
Right. Now, here's how it'll work. Chomper will chase us around, pretending he's a vicious sharp tooth. Then Littlefoot shows shows up and asks Rhett to help him save everyone.
Grr, grr, grr.
But when Rhett gets scared, Allie will see he's been making up all of those stories. See? If we all pretend right, it'll work.
I can pretend to be scared in Yup, Yup, Yup.
Oh, me good at being scared.
I'm not sure about this.
Come on, Littlefoot. It's a great plan. What can possibly go wrong?
What do you think, Chomper?
It sounds kind of fun to me. As long as nobody gets hurt.
Nobody will get hurt? We're all just going to be pretending.
Then it sounds like I'll be pretending to have friends for dinner.
Friends for dinner.
Pretend to have friends for dinner.
We'll say he wants three horn soup
and Littlefoot stew.
It might be funny when he chew on you.
That's not a very nice thing to do.
To have friends for dinner.
Friends for dinner.
Don't wanna be friends for dinner.
Don't wanna be Spike a la Mode or Flivver of Duck.
You think that tastes good?
Yuck! You know you've run out of luck when you're friends for dinner.
Friends for dinner.
Friends for dinner. My friends for dinner.
So, Littlefoot, what do you say now?
It probably would show Allie that Rhett's not so brave. Okay, let's do it.
Ready? And go!
Grr!
Come on, guys! You're supposed to be scared! And you're supposed to be scary! Guys, be serious. Start again.
Ah, he hungry, me scared.
And I am even more scared-ed.
We need help to be saved.
Perfect. Now rush in and stand right next to me, Littlefoot. Let's try it one more time.
Ah, he hungry, me scared.
And I am even more scared than it.
We need help to be saved.
Come on, Rhett, help me save him.
Perfect. Now let's go.
Time to show Allie what Rhett is really like.
Come on, let's play rescue.
Again? Could we play tag instead? Or the pointy seat game? Or swimmer splasher?
Rescue it is! Start yelling help! You sound different.
That wasn't me. That was someone who really needs help. Rescue them, Rhett! Help!
Ah! He hungry! Me scared!
And I am even more scared than it.
We need help to be saved! Who's chasing you?
Who's hungry?
He is!
We gotta save everyone!
Save him yourself! I'm getting out of here!
What's going on?
We wanted to show you that Rhett wasn't as brave as he said he was, so I came up with this plan.
But that shark tooth, where did he come from?
Oh, sorry, Allie. Meet Chomper.
Hi, Allie. Sorry if I scared you.
You're friends with a sharp tooth?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Chomper and Ruby live in the secret caverns.
It's kind of a long story.
But one thing's for sure, we are not afraid to play with Chomper.
So what do you think? Do you want to play with us?
Well, sure. I guess Rhett isn't as brave as he says he is.
Where'd he go, anyway?
There he is!
We must drive that vicious sharp tooth out of the Great Valley! Talking sharp tooth? I've never heard of such a thing.
The sharp
this
tooth
can't do without me.
He's a sharp tooth. Who cares if he talks? Let's get rid of him.
I suppose we must.
Old one, wait!
Chomper's our friend. He lives here.
And he would never hurt any of us!
But he was chasing you. You were calling for help.
They wanted to show me that all of Rhett's stories were made up.
Stories? What stories?
He kept telling me that he saved his herd from many sharp teeth before we met them.
Rhett, come forward.
Thank you.
Yes?
Did you make up stories to fool these children?
It's okay, Rhett.
Yes, I did. I'm sorry.
Little ones, this is very serious. Did you see what happened when you tried to fool each other?
Yes,
I guess so.
You may have wanted it to be a joke, but a sharp tooth attack is no laughing matter.
We're all really sorry, old one.
And as for you...
Yes?
I don't know how you became friends with so many here in the Great Valley. But I think it's good. Longnecks, follow me!
We can play now. We can, we can.
Me not it if we play tag.
I'm too tired to be it. Hey, Rhett. Want to play tag?
But I made up all my adventures.
It doesn't mean we can't all have new adventures.
Come on, Rhett. What are you waiting for?
You guys are the best!
Okay, Spike, you're it!
And that one's like a big hopper.
That doesn't look like a hopper.
You must use your imagination, Sarah. Yep, yep, yep. It won't look like what it's supposed to look like unless you can imagine it.
I still don't see a hopper.
Okay, Ducky, your turn.
That one looks like sweet bubbles.
Oh, I am sorry, Spike. It only looks like sweet bubbles, but it is not. No, no, no. But maybe you can find some in the trees.
Hey! Look at that one!
Chomper!
And he is eating the sweet bubbles.
But I don't even like sweet bubbles. Petrie? Spike?
Spike, what you do? Oh, no! No!
All I see is the day in front of us.
All I see is the day in front of us.
Burning bright with a newborn sun.
Burning
bright with a newborn sun. Come follow me. Hills to climb and the valleys to roam. Streams to follow our way home to the land before time. Before time.
Spike? Spike? What is wrong?
No, it's too horrible to say. Me not believe it.
Spike, are you sick inside? Oh, you just ate red tree stars.
He eats tickly red tree stars.
And?
Everyone know you no eat tickly tree stars. Tickly tree stars bad luck. Everyone know that.
No one knows that. I've seen this before. It's rare and very sweet. But it doesn't bring bad luck.
Spike, no! Give me bad luck, tree stars! Me not fall if Spike not eat tree stars.
That's not why you fell.
Look, Petrie, if Spike doesn't eat any more tickly tree stars, will you stop talking about bad luck?
No, it not okay. Me Uncle Tirano, no leaf eater, who no leaf eater, who eat it and get bad luck.
Uncle Tirano, that guy's full of crazy stories.
Me no, and me not stop thinking about them.
So try to think about something you're not thinking about.
Like what?
What about a different story? Ruby is a good storyteller. Yep, yep, yep.
Sure. How about one that takes place in the mysterious beyond? Chomper and I were on our way to the Great Valley, and Red Claw was trying to stop us.
What is that smell?
I don't smell anything, but your sniffer does smell more smells than mine.
Ew, it's awful.
More awful than getting caught by Red Claw? Then follow me while I lead. It.
Wait a minute. You're telling me water just jumped out of the ground? You have some imagination, Ruby.
But I saw it too.
Yeah, right.
Well, maybe it's something you have to see yourself to know you saw it.
Huh? You want us to go to the mysterious beyond just to see waters jump?
No, Sarah. Though, it's really not that far into the mysterious beyond.
Yeah, it's just beyond the sheltering grass.
I would like to see the waters that jump into the sky. Yup, yup, yup.
I'd like to see it too.
I don't believe you guys are serious about this.
You'll believe it when you see it.
Adventuring, adventuring. To the jumping water place.
You really think that water jumps? How about rocks or big tree stumps?
And what if bad luck come with us?
Don't make a fuss.
I know the meadow's really there.
There's jumping water.
Okay, fine. Let's go see this water that supposedly jumps.
I cannot wait to see water that jumps. Yup, yup, yup.
Hmm.
What's wrong, Ruby?
Nothing. Just, this tree isn't as familiar as I remembered it.
We lost! Oh, this is Spike's fault. He ate bad luck tree stars.
How can we be lost when we're going somewhere that doesn't even exist?
Oh, wait. We just go this way. And we're on our way.
See, Petrie? Nothing bad has happened. There's no reason to be scared of bad luck.
It have been good trips so far. Maybe bad luck get lost instead of us. Maybe we have good trip.
It's okay. It's probably just...
Want to go back, that's okay with us.
Me too.
Well, I'm not a scaredy egg.
Petrie, big scaredy egg. Oh, too big a scaredy egg to go back alone, that for sure. Hey, wait for me. Something bad happened?
No, everything's fine. Let's go.
Littlefoot, you are not walking the way you usually do.
Don't worry about it.
We wouldn't have to worry if we knew what not to worry about.
I stepped on a ground prickly.
Oh, no, no, no!
Shh. It doesn't hurt that bad. But if Petrie finds out...
He'll think it's bad luck that brought you bad luck.
Me feel bad, Spike, so hungry.
Yeah, and whose fault is that? If you weren't so afraid of bad luck, maybe he could eat.
Spike, maybe you'll find delicious no bad luck tree star there.
Spike, what are you doing?
Uh-oh.
Kick it out! Spike, why do you have a log on your head?
Because Spike have bad luck. And because me think they're tree stars in log.
Careful, Spike!
Duck! Spike! Up! Down! No!
See? Spike never should eat bad luck plant.
No, Petrie. You're saying that he has bad luck is the problem.
Huh?
This all Spike's fault!
Surprise, Skywater happens all the time!
zombies we saw earlier usually mean Skywater later.
But still...
Could we talk about this somewhere drier?
Look! The water's jumping!
If Ruby says there is water that jumped, then I know there is. And I want to see it.
Well, we're not going anywhere with all this... Skywater?
Hey! The bright circle is coming out from behind the sky puffies.
Then we will go see the waters that jump. Yup, yup, yup.
But nothing else better happen.
The sky water caused the running mud. That's all.
But what caused the sky water?
And sky fire. Sky fire, bad luck.
And you got a ground prickly in your foot.
Ground prickly? Oh, that very bad luck.
Thanks, Ducky.
Well, we're not having all bad luck. The running mud slid us all the way to the end of the sheltering grass.
Okay. Everybody ready? I think
so. Yes. Yes.
No. Well, let's get this over with.
Everything's going to be fine.
Everything fine. Everything fine, everything fine, everything fine, everything fine, everything fine.
We're almost where we're going.
I think she's right, because I can smell something.
It's not so bad once you get past the stinky pools, remember?
That sure smells bad.
Yep, yep, yep.
I still don't see jumping water.
Wow.
Yes, yes, yes.
Just wait. You still have to see what you haven't seen yet.
Now, do you believe the jumping waters exist, Sarah?
Covered in mud, but I am glad you are okay. Yup, yup, yup.
Uh-oh, Spike. The stinky pools have made you stinky. Worse than usual.
See? Bad luck. Oh, this day doomed from the start.
Let's just get him cleaned up.
Stay there.
Does he still smell bad? We get the mud off.
Whew. Oh, he still smells. Bad luck.
Well, we have to go home now anyway. I can still smell him.
From now on, everybody listen to Petrie. Petrie, right. Spike make bad luck when he eat tickly red tree stars.
You know, Petrie, I...
You do, Chomper. Sharp teeth like you can smell things much better than we do.
So if we don't like the smell, Red Claw must hate it.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you!
Thank you!
Spike! Oh, Spike! It's good luck you fell in mud and smell so bad.
Wait! First it was bad luck, now it's good luck?
It wasn't good luck. It was good thinking. Right, Spike?
First time for everything.
Good luck, bad luck, me no care. As long as we safe. Thank you, Spike.
Your smell is not so bad. No, no, no.
Those tree sweets look delicious. I can't wait for them to fall from the trees.
You won't have to wait another moment, Tria. Not while I'm around.
for you, Tria.
Oh, thank you, Topsy.
Ugh, grown-ups.
You see, Sarah? Three horns can do anything they set their mind to, and be the best at it, too.
All I see is the day in front of us.
All I see is the day in front of us.
Burning bright with a newborn sun.
Burning
come follow me. Hills to climb and valleys to roam. Oh, streams to follow all the way home. To the land before time.
Think three horns can do anything they set their mind to?
Of course I do, Sarah.
Now, Topsy.
Well, I'm glad someone believes me.
I wish it were true.
It is true, Sarah. You're a three horn, so be proud. We're the best among the crowd. You know that we can do what we set our minds to. Do anything. Listen while I sing. You can do anything if you just watch me. You will agree. Trees are no match for my leg. Watch this rock crack like an egg. My horns slice, and yes, there's more. I can really roar, do anything. Come and join me, sing.
We can do anything. Three horns are the best. Put us to the test. We'll do anything.
You see, Sarah?
I do now. Three horns really can do anything.
Look, everybody, I have a new trick. I call it log running. If you watch carefully, you can do it too. First, you get on the log. This is the hard part. Then, you stand up. This is the harder part. Do not fall off. The hardest part is next. Now, you start running on top of the log. The faster, the better. Now I am going faster and faster. Go, go, go!
Whoa, that looks like fun.
Log running is fun. Yes, yes, yes. learn. I can show you how to do it. I can.
Hey, I'll give it a try, Ducky. So what if I get a little wet?
Move over. I'm gonna try, too. Come on, Petrie.
Petrie, not sure. Littlefoot, try?
Oh, no. Not me, Petrie.
Hmm?
Four-footers like us can't get our feet that close together when we run. But it sure is fun to watch.
Okay, here goes nothing.
That was fun, while it lasted.
It doesn't look that hard. See? It's easy. Come on, Petrie, your turn.
Petrie, not sure about this. Me not good runner like Chomper, me flyer.
Well then, if you start to fall, you can always fly off the log, Petrie.
Oh yeah, me can fly. Okay, me try.
You won!
Up.
Guess it's not so easy after all.
We just need to practice until practice isn't practice anymore.
Yeah, we could get as good as Ducky, or even better.
Chomper, you are not better than me at log running. Oh, no, no, no.
Hey, why don't you practice? Then, when we're all ready, we can have a game to see who can log run the longest.
This is going to be a fun game, especially when I win!
Don't count your hatchlings before they hatch, Chomper.
Me agree, because me going to win.
Oh, no, no, no! I will win! Once I can get back on my log.
Hi, guys! What game is this?
The Great Log Running Game. Chomper, Ruby, Petrie, and Ducky are going to see who can stay on their log the longest. Look at them go! That's a game for two-footers, not four-footers like us.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Whoa. Oh. This log running doesn't look so hard to me.
Huh?
Three horns can do anything better than anyone, two-footer or four. That's a fact. Just watch. Step aside, two-footers. Let me show you how a real champion does it. Thanks for helping, Spike. See you back at the watering place.
Okay, tell me, why are you limping?
I slipped off a log. No big deal.
Oh, yes, it is. Your ankle is all swollen up. Here, these will ease the pain. Patricia, you bring some nice soothing mud and put it on the hurt.
Don't bother with the mud. I've got to get back to practice log running.
I don't think so. You'll be okay, but you need to stay off that ankle for a while, Sarah.
I didn't ask for a mud bath.
This is really fun!
Sure is!
Me want to have fun too. Somebody hurry up and fall!
We need another log, Petrie. Come on, Spike. What do you think, Spike? Can you knock one down? Wow, you make it look so easy. Okay, let's go. Petrie.
Thanks, guys.
You and Spike should give it a try, Littlefoot. It's really fun.
Oh, no, not us. You saw what happened to Sarah.
Well, feels pretty good. Thanks for helping.
Are you sure your ankle is okay?
I'm sure. Time to go win that log running game. It'll be so easy.
If it's so easy, how did you hurt your ankle?
Accidents happen, but I can handle it. I'm a three horn.
That's what I'm afraid of.
What are you afraid of?
Oh, nothing, Topsy. It's just Sarah twisted her ankle at the watering place, but she says it's okay now.
Of course it's okay. Takes more than a bad ankle to keep a good tree horn down.
Dad's right, Tria. I'm feeling fine. Ready to go back and tackle my log again. I want to win that game.
Log? Game? What's all this?
My friends are playing a log running game, Dad, and I'm gonna win.
Well, just what exactly is log running?
Well, you get on the log in the water, and then you start running, and the log spins as you run. It's easy.
Why would you want to do something silly like that?
To prove that three horns can do anything they set their mind to and be the best at it. Remember? Just like you said, Dad.
Well, of course three horns can do anything they set their mind to. They just don't set their mind to things like log running.
But, Dad, you didn't say anything about that. You said three horns could do anything.
Yes, just not that. You can forget about playing that game, Sarah. Some things just aren't meant to be.
I still feel the way I did before.
there's only one thing to do. I gotta prove to everyone that I can win that log running game.
Okay, everybody. Let's start the great log running game. On your mark, get set, go!
Huh? Oh, dear. Wally! Oh, no. Me done.
Ducky, Ruby, and Chomper have gotten really good. This game might take a while.
Hold it! Stop the game!
I am the only one still going.
Do I win?
Yes, Ducky, you...
Not so fast. You guys started without me, but the game doesn't count unless I'm playing too.
But Sarah, what about your ankle? You shouldn't...
My ankle is fine. Where's my log? Never mind, I'll get my own.
Ducky not win?
Well, sort of, but not really.
I do not care. It is just a game.
Just a game. I'll show 'em. Three horns can do anything they set their mind to.
So why can't I get on top of this dumb log?
Whoa!
Watch out, Sarah! You're getting too close to the fast water!
I can handle it!
I'm a three horn!
Uh-oh.
We have to stop her, or she'll end up going over Roaring Falls. Ruby, Chomper, Ducky, use your logs to try to catch up with Sarah.
Right. Let's get moving and go!
Be careful! We don't want to have to save you, too! Fast water log runners to the rescue!
Littlefoot, need help, too!
Okay, Petrie, you keep an eye on Sarah from the sky.
Tria, have you seen Sarah?
No, dear.
Well, I'm going to go look for her. If she's gone to the watering place to play that silly game after I told her not to, why, I'll...
I know. You're going to be very upset. Remember, Topsy, you were young once, too.
I was? Then that's where I'm going. That rock could block the fast water and stop Sarah from going over the falls.
But Mr. Threehorn, it's so big. No one can move it.
A Threehorn can. If he sets his mind to it. Now watch me.
Help!
Okay, boys. All together now.
Hurry! She almost here!
Thanks, guys. I'm sorry I disobeyed you, Dad.
You better be. But I'm so glad that you're all right.
We did not finish our game, Sarah. Do you still want to play?
No, thank you.
I think Sarah's learned her lesson.
Lesson? I don't have anything to prove. After all, I stayed on my log all the way down the fast water.